Welcome to the session on the SQL, NoSQL and NewSQL. In this session, we'll be learning about all these one. Talking about the learning outcomes of this session, you will be able to define NewSQL and compare and differentiate between all these three. Let us move ahead. Here we are comparing SQL and NoSQL. What is exactly the difference and how we can compare these one? Now, SQL, all of us are knowing that it's a relational database, okay, whereas NoSQL, it is not supporting the relational database and it is basically used for distributed database. Now, SQL is supporting the relational model, whereas NoSQL, it is totally a modelless approach, okay, here no relational model is applied. In SQL, the predefined schemas are there, already we know the table schema, okay, the format of it, the attributes and all that. Whereas in NoSQL, there is not such a schema or any of the attributes, you can say. And SQL is, as it is a schema based one, it is of the table based one, where rows and columns are there, the data is stored in rows and columns. Whereas in NoSQL, there is variety of the format. Okay, actually it is supporting the unstructured data, therefore it may support key value pairs are used for storing the data, or document based storage is there, column oriented is there, graph based database is there. So these types already we have discussed in my earlier video. Now SQL, it is vertically scalable. Why it is called as vertically scalable? Because as on the system resources we are incrementing, okay, or we are increasing, okay, that it is scaling. Whereas the NoSQL, it is horizontally scalable. Why? Because as on the cluster, the commodity machines, okay, are increasing, the processing power increases and the speed increases, that will happen. Okay, so that is what the therefore NoSQL is a horizontally scalable one. Now talking about what SQL is doing, obviously it is using SQL, whereas this NoSQL, it is totally supporting unstructured query language, which is called as UnSQL. Okay, it is supporting unstructured query language. SQL is not at all supporting the large data sets, okay, it may work on that, but the speed of the execution matters, the size matters, the storage matters there, whereas in NoSQL, it is specially preferred for the large data sets only. Now, for NoSQL, it is best fit for all the hierarchical storage, okay, why? Because it is supporting key value pair and all that, even it is supporting the JSON format also. So it is best fit for that one, whereas SQL, it is not at all fitting for the hierarchical data construct. Why? It is supporting the tabular data, we can say. Obviously, SQL is emphasizing all the ACID properties, whereas NoSQL, it is supporting the Brewer's theorem, CAP theorem, where only any two of them are available. Okay, we cannot support all three things like consistency, availability and partition tolerance in a single one. Okay, any two of them are working according to the Brewer's theorem. Now, SQL, as it is totally a database management system, okay, it is totally the support is from the vendors. As on the requirements are there, based on that the vendors can provide the things. Whereas in NoSQL, okay, it is totally supporting the community, things are coming in this one. Okay, so it is heavily supported by the community. NoSQL, it is not have good support for complex querying. Okay, simple querying we are working on that. Whereas SQL, it is basically used for complex querying. Okay, it is according to the needs. Okay, the queries you can increase or it can support all the types of complex queries. Okay, it is strongly configured for strong consistency. Whereas for NoSQL, okay, support is there for strong consistency in the type of MongoDB or somewhere, but others those are eventually having the consistency there. Okay, so that is a major thing here, that is like Cassandra. Okay, it is eventually providing the consistency. So few examples of SQL are what the normal RD relational databases like Oracle, DB2, MySQL, PostgreSQL and all those. Whereas NoSQL, there are many more types are there, like MongoDB is there, HBase is there, Cassandra is there, CouchDB is there, okay, Neo4j is there, everyone is having its own different format there for storing the data, as it is supporting the unstructured one. Now, what is this NewSQL? We have just seen the difference between SQL and NoSQL, that how they are supporting and all. But talking about the new SQL, what exactly this new SQL is? It is, you can say, the combination of SQL and NoSQL. Okay, it is a new approach where both possible words, like the modern programming language, as well as which one is not available earlier. Okay, and but it is combining ACID also, ACID properties also, which are there in the SQL. Okay, it is providing the scalability, it is providing the high performance. Okay, the combination of that one, you can say. Okay, what it is combining? It is combining ACID properties as well as providing the high performance like NoSQL. So it is having the scalable performance of NoSQL and also support ACID property of traditional databases. So you can say that new SQL is a combination of these two. Pause the video and think about what exactly this new SQL is, then how we can manage it, because as we are saying that it's a combination of SQL and NoSQL, okay, how it is working. Basically, we know that it is supporting the programming language, the proper programming, query programming language, as well as it is supporting the facilities of NoSQL. Talking about the characteristics of new SQL, SQL interface is for application interaction. Okay, it is using the SQL-like interface for application interaction, because SQL-like interaction is interface is used by many of the RDBMS management systems. It is supporting ACID properties, okay, for any kind of transactions. Then as on the nodes are increasing, the performance is increasing for the RDBMS solution, because usually we know that RDBMS solutions are not having that much performance based one. As on the data increases, okay, as it is vertically scalable, okay, but this architecture is providing higher per node performance with regard to the RDBMS one generally. And it is based on, totally based on the shared nothing architecture. So it is scaling out based on the shared nothing architecture. Concurrency control mechanism, it is totally supporting non-locking concurrency control mechanism. So whatever the real-time reads are there, those are not conflicting with the writes. Why? Because it is supporting non-locking concurrency control in this one. Now here we will see the comparison of SQL, NoSQL and NewSQL. A few characteristics we have defined here, like adherence to ACID properties, OLTP OLAP, scalability, distributed computing, adherence to data model, schema rigidity and community support. Let us see one by one all these one, that how where SQL is supporting, where NoSQL is there and where NewSQL is there. So adherence to ACID properties, SQL is supporting, that all of us are knowing that it is supporting, and new SQL is also supporting, whereas no SQL is not supporting ACID property because it is supporting CAP theorem, Brewer's theorem. OLTP and online analysis processing, these one are supported by SQL as well as new SQL, whereas no SQL is not supporting on OLAP or OLTP. Talking about the scalability, for scalability, scaling out is there, horizontal scaling is proposed by NoSQL and NewSQL, whereas SQL is supporting vertical scaling. Why? Because horizontal scaling is applied to both NoSQL as well as NewSQL. So commodity hardware, commodity support is also available in this one. And distributed computing, yes, all of these three are supporting distributed computing. Okay, but highly the proper distributed computing is used by NoSQL and later on NewSQL and then SQL. The data model, talking about the adherence to data model, it is totally relational model, database model in SQL, whereas NoSQL is not supporting any kind of data model. Okay, it is not supporting that, whereas NewSQL, it is supporting the data model. Okay, we cannot say directly the relational model, but it is supporting the data model. Why? It is a combination of SQL and NoSQL. Talking about the schema rigidity, in SQL, yes, it is rigid because we know that the schema oriented data is there. Okay, rows and columns, in rows and columns the data is available, in this one the data is stored, therefore the rigidity is available for SQL. Whereas for NoSQL there is no such rigidity because it is not supporting schema oriented data. Okay, NewSQL we may say it is providing rigidity in this one for schema, okay, or it is not providing, because it depends upon, as it is a combination of both, it depends upon the type of schema we are using in this one. For community software or support, you can say that SQL is having a huge support because it is providing the vendor support also in this one, whereas in NoSQL the community support is growing day by day, and for new SQL it is slowly growing. So these are few you can say the comparisons of this one. So in this video we have learned the new thing as new SQL, and then we have compared SQL, NoSQL, as well as finally we have seen the comparison of all these three. So this is all about this video. These are my references. Thank you.